Hi. Welcome to our Christmas show. We hope you can be with your loved ones this Christmas, and if you can or if you can't, I'd like to invite you for the next hour to share just a little bit of Christmas with my family and with my friends. And to answer a lot of requests, and especially for his sisters, Roseanne, Kathy, Cindy, and Tara, little John Carter Cash is going to come by if he doesn't get too sleepy. The occasion for all this celebration, for this happy gathering, is to celebrate the birthday of the Prince of Peace, the King of Love, Jesus of Nazareth. Join us, will you? Hi. Hi, guys. Hi, baby. How you doing?
On the first day of Christmas, my true love sent to me a partridge in a pear tree. On the second day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
two turtle doves
and a partridge in a pear tree. On the third day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
three French hens,
two turtle doves
and a partridge in a pear tree. On the fourth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
four calling birds,
three French hens,
two turtle doves
and a partridge in a pear tree. On the fifth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
five golden rings,
four calling birds,
three French hens,
two turtle doves
and a partridge in a pear tree. On the sixth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
six geese a-laying,
five golden rings,
four calling birds,
three French hens,
two turtle doves,
and a partridge in a pear tree. On the seventh day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
seven swan a-swimming,
six geese a-laying, four calling birds,
three French hens,
two turtle doves,
and a partridge in a pear tree.
On the eighth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
eight maids a-milking,
seven swan a-swimming,
six geese a-laying,
five golden rings,
four calling birds,
three French hens,
two turtle doves,
and a partridge in a pear tree.
On the ninth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
nine ladies dancing,
eight maids a-milking,
seven swans a-swimming,
six geese a-laying,
five golden rings,
four calling birds,
three French hens,
two turtle doves,
and a partridge in a pear tree.
On the tenth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
10 lords a-leaping,
9 ladies dancing,
8 maids a-milking,
7 swan a-swimming,
6 geese a-laying,
5 golden rings,
4 calling birds,
3 French hens,
2 turtle doves,
and a partridge in a pear tree.
On the 11th day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
11 pipers piping,
10 lords a-leaping,
9 ladies dancing,
8 maids a-milking,
7 swan a-swimming,
6 geese a-laying,
5 golden rings,
4 calling birds,
3 French hens,
2 turtle doves,
and a partridge in a pear tree.
On the 12th day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
12 drummers drumming,
11 pipers piping,
10 lords a-leaping,
9 ladies dancing,
8 maids a-milking,
7 swan a-swimming,
6 geese a-laying,
5 golden rings,
4 calling birds,
3 French hens,
2 turtle doves,
and a partridge in a pear tree.
Yeah. The Johnny Cash Christmas Show, with Johnny's guests, Tommy Cash, the Everly Brothers, Ike Everly, George Gobel, Joe Higgins, Roy Orbison, Cousin Minnie Pearl, the Carter Family, the Statler Brothers, Carl Perkins, the Tennessee Three, and John's mom and dad, Mr. and Mrs. Ray Cash. The Johnny Cash Christmas Show.
Hey, we got Don and Phil, the Everly Brothers, here with us. They're glad to have you, fella.
Hey, thank you, Johnny.
And their daddy, Ike Everly. It's a pleasure to have you with us.
Happy to be here, John.
My brother, Tommy Cash. Thanks for coming by, Tommy.
Thank you.
Tommy's nice been on the road a whole bunch lately. Glad to have you.
Thank you.
What do you say? Do what you do, do well, boy. Do what you do, do well. Oh, give all your love and all of your heart. And do what you do, do well. Hey, Tommy, what do you like to sing?
Well, I'd like to sing a song that Carl Perkins wrote for me a few months ago that I think
Letter
had a good bit to say for everybody.
Letter it.
Little children, do not worry. You've still got lots of time. There's no need in walking backwards. Turn around and rise and shine. If your load always seems heavy and you're always left behind, pick yourself up from the ground and jump right back and rise and shine. Rise and shine in the early morning. Shine your light all through the day. Makes no difference what they tell you. Stand right up and have your say. Cause the good Lord said he loved you. And through him new strength you'll find. Even though the world may use you, get up now, go rise and shine.
That's a good idea, boy. That's a good
Do what you do, do well, boy. Do what you do, do well. Oh, give all your love and all of your heart, and do what you do, do well.
Mr. Ike, we was talking about this song you got called Muskrat.
Yeah.
For years, Merle Travis, you know Merle, he's an old friend of yours too, he called me Mushog or Muskrat.
He called you.
And I never thought anything about it, you know, but it got to eating on me after a while, and one day I asked him, I said, Travis, what do you call me Mushog for, or Muskrat? And he just grinned. He wouldn't tell me. I got to thinking about it a little bit later, you know. Any musk animal's got an awful smell about it. You reckon he was trying to tell me something?
I don't think so.
Let's do a little Muskrat.
What do you say? Let's go.
Muskrat, Muskrat, what makes your head so sleek? Been living in the water all of my life. It's a wonder I ain't sick. 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 Come on, get up. Come on, get up.
Woo-haw! There it is, Mike.
Rooster, rooster, what makes your claws so hard? Been scratching in the barnyard all my life. It's a wonder I ain't tired. I ain't tired. I ain't tired. I ain't tired. I ain't tired.
It's tough. What's your language there, Dad?
Let's see about that old tomcat. Tomcat, tomcat, what makes your tail so long? Let's hear some tomcats out there now. That's pretty good tomcats, but I want you to listen to this.
Meow.
Well, I'm not the tomcat I used to be. Been prowling around all my life. It's a wonder I ain't gone, I ain't gone, I ain't gone, I ain't gone, I ain't gone.
Do what you do, do well, boy. Do what you do, do well. Oh, give all your love and all of your heart, and do what you do, do well.
Don, Phil, you know what I enjoy most about your records, the songs you've recorded? What I like best is the old folk songs.
Yeah.
You really do a beautiful job on them.
In a vine-covered shack in the mountains, bravely fighting the battle of time, is a dear one whose withered life sorrow is that silver-haired daddy of mine. If I could recall all the heartaches dear old daddy I've caused you to bear, if I could erase those lines from your face and turn back the gold to your hair, if God would but grant me the power just to turn back the pages of time, I'd give all I own if I could but atone to that silver-haired daddy. Just to turn back the pages of time, I'd give all I own if I could but atone to that silver-haired daddy of mine.
Hey, that's great.
Beautiful song.
We've had a lot of requests on the show for that song. I'm sure glad you could sing it for us. Do what you do, do well, boy. Do what you do, do well. Oh, give of your love and all of your heart, and do what you do, do well.
John, you do something.
All right.
Tell you what he does well. I remember he used to pick cotton pretty well.
I used to pick cotton pretty well, you know, and speaking of picking the cotton, some songs don't tell it like it is, but they're worth singing because they're good songs.
That's right.
When I was just a baby, too little for a cotton sack, I prayed in the dirt while the others worked till they couldn't straighten up their backs. And I made myself a promise when I was big enough to run that I'd never stay a single day in that Oklahoma sun. And I never picked cotton like my mother did and my brother did and my sister did. My daddy died young working in a coal mine. It was Saturday night in Memphis when a fella grabbed my shirt and he said, go back to your cotton sack. I left him dying in the dirt. And they'll take me in the morning to the gallows just outside. And in the time I got, there ain't a heck of a lot that I can look back on with pride, except I never picked cotton like my mother did and my brother did and my sister did and my daddy died young working in a coal mine. Do what you do, do well, boy. Do what you do, do well. Oh, give of your love and all of your heart, and do what you do, do well. Take us home now, Ike. He's doing all right, ain't he, Mama?
He's doing fine.
Turn around.
Turn around.
Turn around and you're a young man with babes of your own. With babes of your own. Many years ago, they lived a famous country singer by the name of John Cratchit. Cratchit was poverty-stricken because of his manager and agent, a man called Sidney Scruggs. Scruggs was a miserly man who kept Cratchit working year after year without a break. And on one very cold December morning at the turn of the century, John Cratchit was summoned to Mr. Scruggs' office.
1,001, 1,002, 1,003, you know, it's funny how time flies when you're enjoying yourself. 1,000. All right, Cratchit, now what is it? You know I'm a busy man. What do you want?
You sent for me, Mr. Scruggs.
Well, now, let's not have any of your lip, Cratchit. You know Glenn Campbell isn't that busy.
Yes, 1,004.
Sir. Sorry. Sorry, don't feed the bulldog. Oh, and incidentally, what is this bill for? A guitar string, 10 cents.
Well, you see, I broke a string on my guitar.
and you bought a new one. Well, isn't it? You know, Cratchit, you are a spendthrift. You should make do with the other strings on your guitar.
There's not any other strings on my guitar.
Well, learn to play the wood.
Well, Mr. Scruggs, I need money for food and clothing and...
Boo! Cratchit, that's a bummer.
But Mr. Scruggs, how about some money to fix up my house? And we got bed bugs and ants and termites.
Humbug!
Yeah, we got some of them, too, I think.
Now, look, Cratchit, you're working. Don't you understand? I've set up another tour for you.
Oh, but Mr. Scruggs, no. Tomorrow night is Christmas Eve. My family, my children, they'll all be looking down the path to see their dear old daddy come home. Their noses will be pressed against the windowpane. They'll all be there to meet me, arms reaching, smiling sweetly, when again I touch the green, green grass of home.
Cratchit, that's beautiful. But the thing is, Cratchit, you're working. Tomorrow night you play Houston, Abilene, Kansas City, and Toledo. And the next night you open in Hawaii. Oh, and incidentally, as you go west, be sure you get gas in San Francisco because it's the last stop before you get to Honolulu. Get your grubby little fingers off.
Well, things look mighty bleak for John Cratchit. He wouldn't be able to spend Christmas Eve at home with his wife and children, but they weren't downhearted. Because what they lacked in material means, they more than made up for in happiness. And they all love to sing.
Okay, don't worry about it, kids. Don't worry, okay. Oh, quiet. Here comes Daddy now.
Hi, how's everybody?
I need a shirt.
I need a coat.
I need some socks.
We need a hit.
I need a bath.
Oh, yeah.
Honey, we don't have much, but one thing about it, the family's always singing.
I know. It's what's driving me crazy.
And how's Tiny Tom today?
Oh, Tiny Tom, poor Tiny. He can't talk. But I think he's happy.
Honey, I have some bad news for you. I'm afraid I won't be able to spend Christmas Eve with you and the children.
Why, that mean old Mr. Scruggs. You mean he's not going to let you spend Christmas Eve at home?
Sorry.
Oh, but we'll want you here. And we'll need you here. And we'll be here waiting. Waiting to meet you. Arms reaching, smiling sweetly when again we touch...
The green, green grass of home.
I tried that, honey, but I still have to work.
Well, just never mind, dear. Just sit down, relax. Relax, dear, and I'll get supper ready.
Oh, thank you. That's a good idea. Where are my slippers?
That's what we're having for supper. Soul food.
Whoa!
Yes, times were hard for the Cratchits. They were beginning to get a little rough for Sidney Scruggs, too. Because on that very night, while he was sleeping, he had three mysterious visitors.
Now I lay me down to sleep, counting money instead of sheep. Some folks say I'm mighty cheap, but so what? Right, Daddy? Good night.
Spender.
Who are you? Where are you? What are you doing here?
You don't remember old Minnie, huh? Well, I was your slave for years, and now you're trying to do the same thing to poor John Cratchit. You're nothing but an old, cheap, miserly, heartless skinflint.
You left out disgusting.
I can't remember everything, but I can remember the way you treated me.
All right, Minnie. What is it you want from me?
I want you to help the Cratchits. They're all very unhappy.
I know that, Minnie, but happiness isn't everything.
Scruggs, each dollar you make forges another link in the devil's chain. Is that what you want? What? Satan's necklace?
Well, maybe a small bracelet.
Oh, I've got to go, Nastruns. I have someone a little more important to honk.
Who's that?
Colonel Sanders.
Ooh, Nick. Finger licking good.
Wake up, boy. You in a heap of trouble now.
Well, officer, what are you doing here?
I'm the ghost of Christmas future.
Well, how come you're dressed like a sheriff?
I'm moonlighting. But you still in a heap of trouble, boy.
Well, what's the matter? Was I sleeping too fast?
Scruggs, I got you marked down for being an old, cheap, miserly, stingy, heartless skin flint.
You know what? You forgot infuriating.
Well, I got you down for a lot of things, boy. Don't say nothing about you being no firebug. Now, you shape up, boy. But I'm going to tow away your bed and lock up your toddy bear.
Not my toddy bear. Sheriff, please don't take my toddy bear. Sheriff, I'll change. I promise I'll change.
That's what they all say. But unless you do, boy, there's going to be enough charges piled up against you, put you away forever.
No, please, no. I'll change, really. Starting tomorrow, I'm going to make it up to the Cratchits, and I'm going to become a better person. And officer, Merry Christmas.
Ho, ho, ho. Humbug, y'all.
As Scruggs had promised, the next day found him a changed man. He greeted the day with a smile instead of a scowl. Meanwhile, back at the Cratchits, John and family were trying to make the most of a lean Christmas.
Oh, I'm so happy we're all together at Christmas, for Christmas dinner. You know, we don't hardly have nothing to eat, but I have a special treat for us. Whoa. Really do. Well, we couldn't afford much, but here it is. A picture of a turkey.
Oh, Mother. Oh, isn't that wonderful?
Isn't that great? Now we have everything. And if only you could be with us Christmas, on Christmas Day, if you didn't have to work for Mr. Scruggs. And if only Tiny Tom could talk.
Well, we've got this much to be thankful for. Everybody gets a piece of the picture.
Yes. If only we had a picture of some cranberry sauce. Yeah. Wouldn't that be great?
Come in, and welcome to the Cratchits.
Hey.
Santa Claus!
Are you really Santa Claus?
No, I'm building a boat in a bottle, and I dropped in to see if you can tell me where I can get a very small jar of poop deck polish.
Oh, wow.
Hey, that ain't Santa Claus. That's Mr. Scruggs.
Right. I am Mr. Scruggs, but I am a new Mr. Scruggs. John and June, I know, have been an old, cheap, miserly, stingy, heartless,
yes,
skinflint.
You forgot disgusting.
Well, tonight I'm going to make it up to all of you. John, you don't have to work tonight. You can take a whole week off.
Yay!
And then I have a present for everybody.
Oh, no. Don't eat the money, Tiny Tom. Well, he doesn't know what money is, Mr. Scruggs. Let me thank you for Tiny Tom. He still hasn't said a word.
Now, Cratchit, the big surprise of the evening. An ordinary Christmas dinner isn't good enough for you and your family because the shabby way I've treated you, I've got to make up for it. I have hired the greatest food consultant in the land to bring you a Christmas dinner from all over the world. And now let's have a big hand for here he is, John Paul Hartley.
Right, Mr. Scruggs, and now for the meal of the century. Mr. Cratchit, this is your dinner. First, from Louisville, Kentucky, a 90-pound turkey from the famous Captain Gobble's Turkey Ranch. Remember, if you want a big bird, talk turkey with Captain Gobble. Next, from the Hollywood Ham Company, 100-pound ham. Remember, when it comes to ham, people go to Hollywood. And now to add a little spice to your Christmas meal, all the way from Ranjitpur, India, marinated mongoose. Remember, Cratchits, if you like mongoose marinated, you'll love Ranjitpur. And finally, from the old Aaron Sod Potato Company, all the way from County Cork, Ireland, a big platter of peeled pickled potatoes packed by Patrick O'Pincus. That's it. That's your meal of the century. My name is John Paul Hartley, and I was brought to you by Sidney Scruggs. Thank you, and Merry Christmas.
Thank you, Mr. Scruggs.
Thank you.
Mr. Scruggs, we certainly do appreciate your generosity, and everybody dig in.
Oh, yes, everybody dig in. Tiny Tom isn't touching his phone. What is the matter? What's wrong, son?
These are the worst potatoes I've ever eaten.
Tiny Tom.
They're the first words he's ever said.
Tiny Tom, why have you waited all these years to speak?
Because up to now, everything was okay.
Well, that just about ends our story, but John Cratchit went on to become a very popular performer until his manager, Sidney Scruggs, decided to change Cratchit's name. Now, today, if somewhere in this land you should see a sign or a poster saying, now appearing, a boy named Sue, go in and give him a listen, would you? He sure would appreciate it. Hey, how's everybody doing? How was the dinner? You enough to eat, Marshall? Good boy. Welcome to our house. After supper at our house, everybody has to sing for their supper. Okay? We got the hot seat right here. Sir? You can't? Well, we'll get you to talk a little bit later on, okay? We got the hot seat right here, and we got a bunch of guitars, and I know we got some great talent here that I think everybody would like to hear perform one more time. And to begin things right now, Johnny Cash would really like to present the Everly Brothers. All right? Hey, I will sit down here and enjoy.
Why don't we do something about home?
That's a good idea.
Christmas is a time for thinking about such things.
Proud of my friends and neighbors that are here at the party, and my next door neighbor right over the hill from me is one of the finest people I've ever known and one of the greatest talents. Roy Orbison. Thank you, buddy. Roy, your records are fantastic. Pretty Woman, I guess, is one of the biggest records of all time. Plus, a lot of the songs you've written have been great, but I'd sure like to just hear the real Roy Orbison.
Okay, this is just me. Pretty paper, pretty ribbons of blue. Crowded streets, busy feet, hustled by him. Downtown shoppers, Christmas is nigh. There he sits, all alone on the sidewalk, hoping that you won't pass him by. Should you stop, better not, much too busy. You're in a hurry, my half time does fly. And in the distance, the ringing of laughter. And in the midst of the laughter, he cries, pretty paper, pretty ribbons of blue. Wrap your presents to your darling from you. Pretty pencils to write, I love you. Pretty paper, pretty ribbons of blue.
Hey, Don Everly. I learned a lot from my daddy when I was growing up, you know, the thing about trains. Learned a lot about trains and other things from my daddy. Did you learn a lot from your daddy when you was coming up?
Quite a bit, yeah.
How about Phil, did he?
Phil, yeah, I guess he did. Some of it rubbed off on him, too.
You guys got a real unusual style of guitar playing and rhythm. Did you learn that from your daddy, Ike?
Yeah, I guess you'd call that sort of Muhlenberg County guitar picking, I guess. We didn't learn as much as we should have, I don't think.
No, I think you guys have got a style of your own, but your dad, Ike Everly, is one of the most imitated guitarists I've ever known. Let's get him up here, boys. Say, Mr. Ike Everly. Glad to have you with us.
I'm happy to be here. Speaking of guitar playing, John, most of the old thumb-pick guitar players played this tune one time or another, and it's called a Cannonball Rag. One of my favorite guitar players, I guess just about my favorite, is Mother Maybelle.
She's a good one, isn't
she? And she's playing a tune backstage there a while ago that I heard her, that I want her to come over here and see if she can teach me a little bit of it.
Oh, Mother Maybelle.
Let's play it together, Maybelle.
You reckon we can do this?
What did you call that tune?
Well, I called it Victor Rag.
All right. You handle that in, and I'll see what I can do over here.
Well, okay, here goes.
You can be with us for this occasion, and we've been proud to have you with us on a lot of our shows within the last few years. You were with us at Folsom Prison. You were with us at the White House. What did you think about meeting the president?
Well, I got a kick out of it. I thought it was something.
What'd you say? Did this president say anything to you when you came through the
Let me tell you how I buttered him up.
Okay.
When we got to him, we were supposed to address him as Mr. President and his wife as Mrs. Nixon. So I shook hands with Mr. President. I told him I considered it a great honor to get to be in the White House and meet him and shake his hand. And before he could say anything, I says, I just want you to know, too, sir, that I think you are making us a wonderful president. And he grabbed me around the shoulder and pulled me over, said, Mr. Cash, says, I want to have my picture made with you. And he told me he would send me a picture, and he sent me a picture about that wide and about that long colored picture, and I've got it hanging up in my home.
Mighty nice man, wasn't he? Sure was kind to us at the White House. Mom, I wish you could have gone with us. Mom wasn't feeling too good that night, but it was a good trip for us. We saved the prettiest and the best for last, and I'd like to ask you to go to the piano and get everybody to join in on a song, your favorite song.
Dedicate this, if I might, to my sister at Fordyce, Arkansas, who is not in the best of health, and I'm sure she will enjoy it.
Hey, Mom. I hope you did enjoy our special Christmas show. Of all the shows we've brought you, it's the one I enjoyed doing the most. To celebrate, I believe, the most important birthday we know, the birth of Jesus of Nazareth. And our friends, Ike, Don, Phil, the Everly Brothers, George Goble, Joe Higgins, Roy Orbison, Minnie Pearl, thanks for coming by. And from the bottom of my heart, I wish that there will always be peace on earth and goodwill toward men. Good night. Merry Christmas.
We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. La 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 la.